have to include motor control, or activation of the proximal muscles surrounding the spine. Or it could be disc bulge, either proper disc bulge, where the nucleus push the annulus to irritate the nerve root, or only disc bulge where the nerve root is not irritated. You know what I mean? We talked about this. So the annulus could be irritated or compressed, and in this case the pain will be across the lower back, or the annulus could be compressed, compressing the nerve root, leading to nerve root irritation and peripheralized symptoms. And finally, we can get nerve root stenosis, or what we call recessive stenosis, where the nerve root gets compressed within the intervertebral foramen, or central stenosis, where the spinal cord is irritated within the canal. And finally, we talked about adherent nerve root or apical nerve root, where patients who had several attacks of low back pain with neural problem or compression of the nerve root, and by time, because we have different process of healing, different process of inflammation, will end up with tightness of lack of flexibility of the nerve root. We call it adherent nerve root. So these are the main pathologies. As you can see in the background, I put facet joint, and I'm sure you will agree with me. With instability, you will find some compression or irritation of the facet joint. So do expect some facet joint-like symptoms with patient with instability. Patient with disc or annular problem, there will be some sort of asymmetry. Do expect some facet joint problem, right? Patient with nerve root irritation, I'm sure you will also expect facet joint, the same for stenosis. That's why I always say facet joint is a secondary problem rather than a primary problem. It's always, or most of the time, could be associated with primary problems rather than to be the main problem itself. Are you all right? Good. Now, let's talk about management. I will start from the bottom, and I think you will agree with me. All these patients, they will need education about their problem. What's going on? What's the treatment? This is my rule, this is your rule. All these patients will need what we call neurophysiology education. We talked about it. The pain could be 2 out of 10, but your brain is telling you it's 8 out of 10. Right? And we know that assurance and education will help increase the endorphin and minimizing this kind of fear avoidance and pain perception beliefs. All of these patients, they will need self-management. We talked about self-management. When we talked about SRJ, we give you self-management techniques. Lumbar spine, we did the same. Shall we talk about it again, trauma? We'll talk about it again later on, okay? Now, let's talk about management. Motor control. The evidence is very poor, right? We have two systematic reviews. 2010, Stephen May, 2014, Peter O'Sullivan, right? They talk about motor control or activation or strengthening abdominal and back muscles is not a treatment for low back pain. However, we can modify the result of this research by saying every single patient with low back pain problems, whatever the cause is, he needs some activation of the abdominal and the back muscles. So abdominal and back strengthening is not a treatment itself in its own, but it's part of the treatment package, right? It's one of the dishes that you give on the table. That's why if you have these two in yellow, motor control, disc or annular, motor control, same for instability. Direction preference, right? Robert McKenzie and Stephen May, 2003, 2006, right? They talked about if we do repeated movement testing and we find directions that decrease the pain, use it. And I'm sure you will agree that we can find this with any mechanical problem. If the problem is mechanical, you definitely will find one direction that decreases the symptoms, great news, use it as a treatment. For all these patients, if there's any stiffness, mobilize. If there's pain, mobilize. So I'm sure you will agree that mobilization techniques that we did, acc- accessory, physiological, or even active could be treatment for most or all of these problems, except instability. There's no point to mobilize unstable patients. Do you agree? Good. And finally, restoring neural mobility. It is adherent nerve root. It is a problem with neural mobility, so we need to glide it, okay? If there's a problem with irritation of the nerve root and the patient is not moving enough, I need to be proactive and move the neural tissues to decrease the pain and to avoid the patient to be an adherent nerve root patient. You agree? Good. So this basically covered everything related to lumbar spine. I'm sure you will agree that treatment response-based diagnosis. We talked about it in block one. If you are in doubt, you don't know exactly what's going on, this patient has unilateral back pain, there's no red flags, I'm very clear here. All what we need to do, mobilize, open. The patient is improving. In this case, the problem could be a facet or nerve root irritation. Sometimes you don't need to really think about the diagnosis, but you need to think more about the treatment itself. Okay? Good. And I'm sure also you agree that we need to consider the same factor, severity, irritability, and nature. I will not mobilize end range or high grade if the patient irritability is high. Is this right? I will definitely go with low grade. So we need to respect the severity and the irritability of symptoms. Okay? Good. We'll sum it up. If you have a second.